All right, hello guys. Welcome to another Train Simulator 2020 video. Today, we're gonna do a little American Iron. In fact, I don't know, this might be the first American Freight run that I've done on the YouTube channel thus far. It won't be the last though. Anyway, we're on the Montana High Line, gonna be doing a little work today. We are running the scenario Westbound Manifest Part 1. It's a 90 minute run. There's no way in hell I'm going to try and upload that to YouTube. It'd take like 7 days. So we're going to cut this in half and do like a part 1.5 or something. Anyway, we're in the BNSF ES44DC. We've got several of them tied on, and we're just about getting ready to go. Dispatch says, BNSF 7200, are you ready to depart? The line is very busy today, and I want you to get rolling as soon as possible. You'll proceed to Pacific Junction on track one. Another train of even higher priority than yours, QCHC PTL 1-09, will overtake you on track two. Follow it onto the High Line as soon as the signal clears. All right, of course, we've got the Searchlight Simulations Gevo enhancement pack, none other. Can't drive one of these without it. Anyway, let's get set up. Got limited clearance, as it did say something's going to be overtaking us here. So Conductor says, let's hang back a little from the other train so we don't have to stop at Pacific Junction. The signal blocks are around 2 miles long. Judging by the urgency in our dispatcher's voice, I reckon we ought to hurry after that intermodal train. Mm-hmm. which should be blowing by us in just a moment. There he comes. And there he goes. Now, while we do have a higher line speed and we're going pretty slow, there's a reason for that. Obviously, this train's going to overtake us, so there's no point in hurrying up just to slow back down. So we're going to let him do his thing, and then we'll carry on. See him round in the bend way up there. All right, so that aspect is definitely a nay-no. And these blocks are 2 miles apart. Like we got some Boeing fuselages back there. Nice. 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 Up there a little bit more. The sky on this route is definitely not its strong point. Go. And just a word to the wise, if you're not listening to this, if you're listening at all, put on some headphones if you got them. Airplane! Alright, for some reason the alerter is stuck on. Eh? That's odd. That is really weird. I've never seen that happen. When it first lit, I was definitely clearing it. These wide open maps like this, that really bad skybox artifact is not hard to miss. All right, distance linked 4,117 feet. I think we still got a flasher and someone waiting on us. Dispatch BNSF 7200, please keep up your speed and follow QCHC pt.1 closely. There are several eastbounds coming your way, and I want you to be on the double track section when you meet him. All right, I'm trying. Anyhow, I've not much gone over this route, Montana Highline. It's really good. It's got some decent speed freight, some pretty common stock comes with it, but sometimes it can be really pretty, with all the different, I don't know, assuming it's grain in, certain parts of the map. That and a lot of the old BNSF material you could not use because of their butt-hurty-esque legal issue. Although this one you can, because if you buy it outside of the United States, you just get debranded BNSF stock. But it's a nice route. It's pretty good speed. It's not like Granger Heartland, which is kind of in a sad state by default. Who knows if that'll ever get rectified, fixed, whatever. But this is the next best thing as far as new routes go. American freight. If you know how to, or if you have the AP weather pack and you know how to work the witchcraft that is adding it to non-UK affiliated routes, it can look much, much better. This, of course, is not an example. That, and there's also a, being that it's new, there's not a whole lot out there in terms of workshop scenarios, but they have already released a scenario pack for the Montana Highline, which also comes with, I think, some P-42DC Southwest Chief scenarios, which of course is Amtrak passenger. But you get quite a few scenarios with the route in its basic form. You get this, which is two parts. There's also a four-part double stack train scenario. A couple of scenarios with the GP38-2 and one or two with the old switcher. I think it's a 1500. Which is, now that I have spoken the words, I do recall I did something on the YouTube channel with this route using that switcher. Here's one of the many grain depots on the map, I believe. It's pretty much what this map in this portion of the land is all about, and it captures it well. All grain harvest and production. Big Sky Country, as it's eloquently named. And it ain't as flat as it looks, as you can now tell. It's like I kind of fell behind the eight ball, building my speed. And as you can see, the HUD's jacked up. I don't know if that's because I added the Searchlight Simulation Pack, which sometimes will do weird things, or if it's hidden instructions, I'm not sure. But we're obviously not 6 miles away from Chester, our destination. Or 43, looks like. I guess it'd be a good time to go over what this train actually is. Man, total professional here. Anyway, this is, like I said, Westbound Manifest. I did not read the briefing, though. It says your train is HDILPAS-1-09. It's just ended a brief layover at Hive Yard and set out some cars. It's now time to proceed to Shelby, where the next crew will take over. Due to blockage on the MRL main line, your train is carrying detoured Boeing fuselages today. They are on their way from Boeing's plant in Wichita, Kansas, to Renton, Washington. Little backstory. Also, as a side note, in case any of you may not know, if you do get this route, you can also get a backdated version of the route on the workshop, which is by the same fella that made the route itself. All you need is a couple of assets off of his website, which are free to download, of course, but it transforms the look from obviously modern to the 50s, I believe, mid-50s, right into the 60s. I've not yet personally done it myself, but I keep meaning to install it and have a look at it. Don't want to overspeed, but I don't want to lose too much speed either, because we're climbing again. And ideally, you don't want to raise the notches up until your amps level out or start to drop, but kind of eager to not lose too much speed. Thank you. miss a whistle board? Is that a crossing? No, just weeds. Weeds can die. Die, weeds! That is a whistle board. Still got everybody hanging on. That's good. I think Boeing would be too happy if some of those fuselages rolled off. All right, down we go. Alright, so 35 miles. Let's take a look at our map here real quick. There he is. There's Q, old Q Chich Piddle. Alright, so I reckon what we'll do is we'll go ahead and pause at Guilford Yard right up there, and we'll kind of make the part one a part two. It's quite a conundrum. Yes, I know, but I don't like trying to upload YouTube videos that are that long because it just takes forever, so we're gonna kind of split it up a little bit.
Thank you.
I wouldn't attribute that stutter to the root either, nor the stock. It could be something running in the background, like that pain in the ass called Windows Defender. It's actually a pretty smooth root. Grain elevators. Got some Angus over there, some future steaks and hamburgers, looking good. This is a neat map too, like some of these small towns and whatnot and farms. If you take a minute and actually look around, you'll find some interesting little scenes. Alright, another climb. This track is like a roller coaster in some parts. We got a fast mover coming at us. I got eastbound intermodal, which is precisely one of the other scenarios that comes with the route. The train right there. It's a big boy. Some DPU. That is a big ass train. Thank you. All right, and that's it for part 1.1. I don't really know how to put it. Anyway, we'll continue on another day with the rest of the scenario. Can't be but about just under 30 miles to go to Chester. Anyway, thanks.